skits here.
Worthless Ryan, pile of shit.
Ryan the illegitimate.
Yeah.
As usual.
The illegal illegitimate.
The illegal illegitimate.
God damn it, I just fucking hate you so much. Hate you.
So we have a great show tonight. Actually, we have no show tonight. We didn't play
what
shit.
What show are we talking about here?
I have no idea.
It can't be our show.
No.
It must be another show on our network.
Another show.
A different one.
Why would they give guys like us a show?
No, they would not.
That's what I've been asking.
They would not.
Oh, hey, Juan's here.
We have a little switch up tonight.
Hey, it's Juan.
We have Juan.
Juanito.
Juan. And let me tell you something about Juan.
What's up?
Juan is a master of a lot of things, and one of the things that he masters at greatly is Micrographics Limited.
Yes.
And they brought us our excellent website.
Yes,
which is fucking awesome.
It is. Thank you, Juan.
Yeah.
Golf clap for Juan there.
Fuck yeah, Juan.
You guys want a website made? Micrographics Limited. We'll let him talk. Go ahead.
A little butt clap would be
good. Well, how can he talk? He has no mic.
He has no mic.
Do me a favor.
If he speaks up, he can hear him.
Please sit next to Ryan.
Ryan, don't pull. No.
I'm not pulling that far.
I'm in the witness protection program. I cannot sit on the couch.
All right. That's fine. Keep it in.
What did you do?
His real name is Frankie Vargas. What do you mean I'm not supposed to?
Oh.
You fucked.
His real name is Jimmy Capone.
Jimmy Hoffa. Didn't you find Jimmy Hoffa once, Johnny?
Once, but we weren't supposed to talk about that either.
Oh, okay.
That was the problem with
Never mind.
Problem with the shift. I always said, how the fuck am I going to be ninja-like, but do a show like the shift? And this is the problem. Now we have stupid shit like this coming up. Names are getting blown up.
Right.
What the fuck?
So I have to ask, I'm noticing an empty spot on the couch there. Where's Vinny?
We have two empty spots, actually.
Well, two, yes. Where's Vinny? And where's Kenny? Well, I have this lovely, lovely lady here in Kenny's place.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'm not really too worried about Kenny's spot.
The Peach and the King of Corpses are currently not around.
Oh, wow. Peach isn't here?
No.
Wow, he's about as useless as fucking Ryan is right now, isn't he?
I'm about to name Peach the illegitimate.
Ryan, you're going to get a new nickname, dude. How do you feel about that? You're
like
not going to be a pile of fucking human excrement anymore.
But that's like the best job there is.
Being what?
Think
a piece of shit?
I don't have to do shit because I am shit.
Shit.
Yeah, you're right.
Shit equals shit.
It really must be an awesome feeling just to be able to sit.
Well, Ryan confessed to me earlier that he's in love with this lovely lady over here.
Oh, I would.
What would you do to her?
I'd wife it up.
I want details.
Wife it up.
Okay, wife it up?
I'd wife it up. Oh, you want bedroom detail?
No, not that far.
What? Okay.
Not that far.
I'd break your mind with some shit.
You'd break my mind?
You wouldn't.
This is the most Ryan has ever talked in his life.
So, you know what sucks? We had, I'm going to be honest about this because, I just got to be honest.
That means he's lying, folks.
No. We had this whole epic idea where we were going to get shit-faced and come on and do the graveyard shift.
Right.
Now, after two 12-packs, I still have some Jack over here, actually.
That's where it was the whole time.
I saw
behind,
the
clear. Behind good old
we're
JFK.
Drinking. We were going to come on shit-faced, and we didn't plan anything for tonight. We were going to come on shit-faced, and we were just going to go all fucking crazy because we were drunk. But
Excuse me.
That much alcohol didn't do it. It didn't do it.
What does that say about us? That we're raging alcoholics?
I don't drink that much, Frank. You know that. Let's be real. I'm not a big drinker.
But Johnny, you understand something. We've put away a lot in our lives, man.
Mm-hmm.
And I think our bodies have just built up a resistance to what would be high amounts of alcohol to normal people, low amounts to us. You know what I mean? So.
Meanwhile, your liver is slow.
Oh, meanwhile, my liver is, he's, that dude's dead. It's completely black. Who's that?
We have
a knock at the door.
Knock at the door. What the fuck? We have a door?
Business.
Who the fuck is this?
What the fuck?
Johnny, who's this?
All your shit all over the place.
Johnny, who's this?
I don't know who the fuck this is.
Ryan knows who he is.
Ryan, you know who this is?
He's coming here for a business meeting.
Oh, that's Clark
right.
Kent.
That's right.
Yeah.
For the Daily
that's
Planet.
Right. This is
the busy.
This is Billy, the business busy businessman.
Yeah, say that 10 times fast.
What the fuck?
Wow.
Talk about
you gonna clean that shit up, motherfucker?
I came on here because I want everybody to know about business. I'm here for the people.
For the people's man.
The people's business?
Alright, listen. Billy.
I made $3 million playing the stock market. I've made $4 million playing the junk bonds. And I've made $17 today, not doing a goddamn thing. So I want to fucking talk to the people out there, the people. And we're going to show them things about how to make annual returns.
Oh, Jesus
Christ. Get their IRAs in progress.
I'm not in the IRA.
It's too much.
I'm not Irish.
It's too much things. I talked to Gypsy, and I have him on my side, and I want him to show me. Gypsy, can you show the people out there graph one? I just want to show them how they can make money. And,
what the fuck? Billy, Billy, I said 11:30 a.m. Yo, Billy, my dude. Billy, when I said I'd have that meeting with you, it was 11:30 a.m.
Yeah,
not p.m.
We're going to make money today, people. We're going to make a lot of money for you. Do you have the graph up, Gypsy?
This is what makes people money in a regular day. Regular day. Now, 3/4 of the money goes to gynecological exams. A lot of it also goes to wrestling moves.
Am I right? Do you do a lot of wrestling moves, John?
He definitely does.
I do. Very nice to see you again.
Hey, how are you, brother?
Very nice to see you again.
Oh, yeah, sure. Guy has no idea. I've never met him before.
Right, and Jonathan.
Yeah.
Bill.
Very nice Bill, to see pleasure. You. Always nice a pleasure, Bill.
Bill, have you been drinking?
You can't remember it. So, a lot of money goes to wrestling moves. The Dow Jones Industrial Average, it says that 1/4 of people read signs every day.
Okay.
Now, well, a lot of it goes to bird watching as well.
So, what are we supposed to be investing in?
No, well, I'll show you in graph 2. What? Gypsy, can you do me a favor? Can you show everybody graph 2?
Oh, I need a shot of Jack, too.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Graph 2.
Frank, this is how your cash dividends go to IRAs.
One.
Ready?
Here.
This is the graph shit in relation to things. Now, if you notice, can you do me a favor? I'm a very busy guy. Can you hold my mic for me?
Oh, my God.
If you notice,
Bill,
the creeps and cretins are in the light green.
The puke green.
Yeah, they've been 4%. For their whole time. The National Association of Securities won't tell you this. I'm going to tell you this. I'm going to tell you that Dow Jones and the security deposit, the initial security deposit that you need, will tell you that minority trolls are coming into our system, and you better know how to very properly adjust to that. The medium annual fucking allocated Social Security bond for a minority troll... It's crazy. Obama can't do nothing about it. He's not going to do anything. So, what you have to look at is the graph of the freak show weirdos. They come up on the top. So, if you're going to invest in anything, ladies and gentlemen, invest in freak show weirdos.
It's spelled wrong.
Listen, we put all of our money into our people. And if our people don't understand the English language... That's not our fucking problem, but we're going to get the facts out to you. So, look at this.
Bill, okay, listen.
Yeah.
Listen.
Okay, I'll take questions on this graph alone.
Okay, I got a question for you. The freak show weirdos. Okay. All right.
In the purple.
In the purple. What am I investing into? Like just one random freak show weirdo? Or is there like a group? Is this a union?
Is it a circus?
See, that's the problem. That's the problem. You guys have to go and go to the newspaper and look up the fucking... It's FMRW. And if you see that and it's negative 2%, you're going to make money. You call somebody. You call a stockbroker. And you say, FMW, negative 2%. And he's going to say...
Where's the N coming from? There's no N in there.
freak show and weirdos. Frank, I can't sit here. I'm way too fucking busy. I'm way too fucking busy for this. Hold on.
Are you too busy to put on a fucking shirt?
I got called last minute. You're lucky I'm doing this show.
Last minute? I told you it was 11:30 a.m., dude. Bill.
We have
worked with each other for such a long time. The last time you did this to me, I'm working, I'm digging a fucking trench trying to install a sprinkler system, and this motherfucker is throwing shit at me, and he's fucking going on throwing grafts in my face while I'm digging a trench.
John, I make more fucking money in 1 minute.
I understand that.
In 1 minute. Because I understand the fucking averages. I understand the bias expectations.
But we're doing the graveyard shift, Bill.
I'm here to show...
We're not here to talk about business.
I know your fan base is a bunch of fucking losers and retards. And I want to make sure they know. I want to make sure you know what dealer's automatic means. I want to make sure you know your objective, whether it be mutual bonds, mutual respect for each other. And if you don't even have a fucking proxy... Are you kidding me? If you don't even have a proxy, show them the third. This is what happens if you don't have a proxy. Can you put the graphic on? Don't put my fucking face because they don't deserve that. This is what happens, Frank.
Yes.
This is in blue is the number of guys with unintentional boners. It reaches 50 every year. Every year. Meanwhile, that's not our fault. It's not our fault. It's not Obama's fault. It's your fault, Frank. But in the red, which is Johnny, the number of women with shit-stained clothes. Now, if you notice, during coitus, there are more women with shit-stained clothes.
Coitus.
And if you have tuberculosis, then there are a lot of guys that have boners that don't need boners if they have tuberculosis. Now, while you're watching the graveyard shift, and I wanted to bring here because I thought you should know. You know, I thought you should know. This is what your show does to people.
It gives men erections.
To everybody what that means.
Wait, but that...
And we attract...
What's the percentile, John? What's the percentile? Don't act like it doesn't exist.
Jesus Christ, 35.
35 percentile. There's a 35 percentile.
He's right.
And it beats the women...
He's 100% correct.
That eat the fucking... That have shit.
So are you telling me... Are you telling me that the show causes obesity?
No.
Pedophilia. And fucking...
Tuberculosis.
Tuberculosis?
You're way off. But if you eat cheeseburgers... If you're eating burgers while watching this show... 22% of the women... That watch this show return to maturity expectations. They have their IRAs. They have their CIAs. They have their government expectancy checks. Now, that's nothing to me. It's nothing to anybody. But I'm going to tell you right now, if you're going to index things and you're going to play that game, you're long gone. Because if you're in church, look at that. 1% of women have shit-stained clothes in church.
Bill.
Meanwhile, 10% of women, 10% of men... Have boners in church. Unexpectedly.
Of course. Dude, it's Sunday morning. Bill, of course you're going to have a boner.
So what are you telling me? What am I supposed to be doing here?
Oh, my God. I can't account. I'm trying to make sure that the market is fair. I can't advise to go this way, to go that way, to go up and down the church street. You know?
You're supposed to be telling me where am I supposed to be going with this business.
I'm a financial analyst.
I'm going to interpretate the tactical asset... Allegations, the TAA. Don't, it's not the TNA, it's the TAAA. There's three T's. TAANA. Okay? So if everybody would just understand. Well, listen.
I have a question from the audience. What if you're eating bagel bites while watching the show?
Oh my God, are you kidding me? You're a simple linear trend. Your trend line has to go way beyond the untactical. Hold on. I got it on my tablet. Unfunded pension plans. There are so many unvented fucking pension plans that if you eat bagel bites while you watch this, you're in another zone. You're zonking. We call that zonking. You're fucking up. You're fucking up at this point. Let's play the last graph. I have a fucking busy business meeting to be to. I'm very fucking busy. There's shit everywhere, and this is disrespectful to me. So, can you, Gypsy, can you put on the last graph? And this is your show.
What do you mean?
This is your show. I took the analyst numbers. I took all the non-ejectives. I took all the IRAs, and I put them all together in one number. And I just want everybody to see. Frank, do you see this?
Yeah.
This is your show.
I don't understand it, though.
Well, if you watch...
Explain it to me.
If you watch the graveyard shift...
Yes.
This is your money market situation. And then it goes to the killer clown. He ate people. So if you watch the shift, this is your palpitations... And this is your political rival. And if you don't proxy at the right time, if you don't proxy, Frank.
Oh, I better proxy then, huh?
Well, the intrinsic values of this is fucking ridiculous. I don't want to become a clown.
Okay, all right.
Is that what you're saying is happening? So is it happening that I'm going to become a clown? I'm going to eat people?
Frank, I don't have time for this anymore. I gave you as much knowledge as you people need to go. Ba-ding, ba-ding, ba-ding. The fucking stock bells is ringing. The stock fucking carts are leaving, and everybody got their fucking, their shrubberies. And you got to fucking invest in fucking pork bellies. And if you don't be an accrued interest.
Oh, my God. Okay.
All right, guys?
All right.
Hey, it was very nice to see you. It was very nice to meet you. A lot of energy in this room. A lot of homosexuality. Makes a lot of money. In these markets, you return to your maturity expectations.
Can't say I'm sad to see you go.
Well, it was very nice to meet you.
Bill. The fuck out of here.
Very nice to meet you, Frank.
Yeah, all right.
Raymond. Bill.
Hey,
it's a pleasure.
I'm glad I got to show all my shit. And don't call me. I'll call you.
Go get a shirt.
Yeah. All right.
That was businessman Billy.
Yeah. Billy, the busy businessman.
Yeah.
We originally had a meeting for tomorrow at 11:30 a.m.
Wow. He must smoke a lot of crack.
No, he doesn't. He's actually straight edge. He doesn't do anything. He doesn't drink.
What the fuck is wrong with him?
He just bursted in here like that straight edge. All right.
I shit you not. Listen, you got to understand something about Billy. All right. He once worked for a child trafficking for slavery. And,
he was a what? He was a human trafficker.
He sold child
slaves? No, he didn't deliver. It wasn't him selling the kids. It was, he just managed the money.
So he was an accountant.
He did the numbers.
Slave. He did the books.
Exactly.
That's so much better.
That's not good.
What do you mean that's not good? The dude knows what he's talking about.
That's not good.
He knows what he's talking about.
Oh.
Why? Because he sold Nigerian kids to Canadians?
Why they gotta be Nigerian, bro? Why can't they be Hungarian or Lithuanian?
You're not supposed to be saying this shit about the Nigerian fucking kids.
It was a good deal. You know, it passed.
Yeah. Who should I fuck up about that?
I don't even know. Let me see this shit. I don't know. Shh.
Anyway. So, completely unplanned show with nothing going on whatsoever. Yeah, right. That's a good idea, Juan. Wants to take anybody.
Yeah, I gotta admit something. I gotta admit something.
What do you mean you gotta admit
something? I gotta admit something. I'm really fucking jealous of Johnny's hair. I finally admitted it. I'm looking at that beautiful head of hair you have over there.
I'm insanely jealous.
Look at that fucking thing.
Why aren't you jealous?
Look at that little fucking Jufro that he has.
What? Why? What's up with my Jufro?
No, I love it. I wish I had that hair.
Was he just jelly Johnny's hair?
No, his hair. I like his hair.
I was just say jelly.
He just said jelly.
You said jelly.
You're jelly.
Wasn't that one of the fucking words we decided to abolish?
Hey, Ryan, why don't you say twerk next?
Can you?
Juan. Juan, do me a favor. Go sit next to Ryan because we can't hear you.
Ryan, go sit next to Juan. Juan, go sit next to Ryan.
Somebody switch.
So Johnny, so listen, shave your hair off and give it to me because you know it's gonna grow back anyway. So.
Do you want me to?
I do. I want to make a wig out of it.
I should.
Yes.
You want me to shave my head?
Yes. And give me the hair.
Frank's new hair.
And give me the hair.
I want them to make a wig out of your hair.
That might be doable.
You think so?
Yes.
You can make money from that selling your hair.
To you?
No, to a wig shop, and they can make me a wig.
No, but we're talking about selling my hair to you.
Oh, well, I'm not going to give you that much.
Oh, how much are you going to give me?
I don't know, $5?
That's what your jealousy is worth?
Yes.
Fuck you, bro. That's what your jealousy... How shallow are you?
Why do I have this stupid
You're
fucking graph in front of me over here? Get out of here. Fuck you and fuck your hair.
Wait a minute. Billy left?
Yeah.
Billy left and didn't pick up any of his
shit.
Oh,
he didn't. You know what? Yeah. When I see him, I'm going to fucking throw him down a flight of stairs.
Oh, fuck that, man.
Push him in front of a bus.
No, hold on. Let me hit him up.
Hit him up.
Get his ass in here.
What happened?
Hold on. Whoa. I just got a text from Billy. He just said he got arrested outside.
For doing what?
For walking out in his boxers.
Yeah, well, told him to put pants and a shirt on. He got his jacket on.
Oh.
Yo!
Hey!
Motherfucker.
I thought you weren't coming tonight.
Thank God he's here.
You gotta come. I wasn't gonna come, man.
Shit.
What's up, dude? What's up, dude? How you doing?
Good shit.
Don't let you rush,
the King
man.
Of Corpses. Has graced us with his presence.
Give me a girl. I'm over here.
Hey, Kenny.
She's sexy.
Oh, she's sexy.
We don't need to have our meeting tomorrow morning.
What happened?
Because Billy showed up tonight.
What do you mean?
He thought.
Well, you noticed the mess all over the floor?
Well, I just thought that was the regular Zidalza fucking network floor. There's always some sort of fucking doo doo or something on the floor.
No, it's
never.
It's always clean.
I swear.
It's usually a little cleaner than this.
Yes, it is. You can eat off the guy.
Well, what happened?
I'll tell you what. Hold on. There's something of all Billy's possessions that spilled out all over the floor. There's actually something very interesting on the floor. I'm gonna pick up and talk about.
You hurry back to the camera.
And Juan, thank you for Jack Daniels.
What is it?
Hold on. Let me take a swig of Jack Daniels first.
Oh, I see what that is.
Ah, yes, yes, yes. Hold on, I'm going to put this up to the camera.
The guy must have had a lot of information. Right. And when I talked to him, he seemed like a quite intelligent fella.
Can we really see this?
Much.
No?
He seemed like a
guy. All right.
This is Saturday, the 26th of October.
That's next Saturday.
Next Saturday.
Yes.
The Shift is having a Halloween party.
It's going to be a party.
Be there.
That's what I heard.
Just be there.
It's going to be good.
Be there. Before that, 2 days before that, the network is having a party over at Garcia's.
Yeah.
Be there.
That's going to be a good party, too.
Yes.
Hey, John.
Be there.
John, this came in from email.
Send it over.
Oh. Oh.
What do we got?
You broke something now. Besides yourself, you broke.
He broke himself.
Hey, Jips, I think I fucked up. I think I signed in as a guest. That's okay, I can still do what I gotta do.
What the fuck? Am I supposed to read this?
Yeah, that's okay. So how do I do such a thing?
Am I supposed to read this?
No.
I don't know, it just came in fucking
via
email,
bro. It's something to file away. Johnny.
I'm confused.
Johnny.
What am I supposed
to do? It's something to file away.
Alright.
What's the thing you saw?
God, you're fucking worthless, I swear to God.
Why am I worthless?
I hate you so much.
Man. The light above you, Frank, it ain't showing.
It's all right.
It ain't showing the beauty that it usually does.
I'm in the dark.
Oh, what the fuck?
I don't want to grace their viewers with my beauty. It's too much. Too much to handle.
Sure about that.
I can see you just fine.
Beauty isn't the word.
What are you talking about? I can see.
It's what's on the inside that counts.
I can see him just fine. He's a shallow, closed-minded piece of shit.
Yep.
He's got a heart.
He does have a heart of gold.
With a heart of gold. Close-minded piece of shit with a heart of gold.
You have a gold, dude? I know. You have a golden chicklet?
I do.
Get the fuck out of here.
I have five.
He has five.
They're all in the back. You can't see them.
No, I can't.
No, you only see them, at night. They shine up. They glisten.
Almost like your head off the light.
Yes. See? My head in the light, my teeth in the dark.
But seriously, if I shave my head and give you my hair...
I'll fucking wear it like a bald cap.
Okay.
Like
we're gonna do this around December.
Yes.
I'm legitly, mark my words, first time ever, shaving my head.
Yes.
But I'm going to let it go into at least a ponytail, probably by December, January.
And then we're going to glue it to my head.
And then we're going to make a cap out of it.
I don't want the mustache. I can grow a mustache myself. Look, see?
Oh,
I got a mustache here.
This mustache.
Welcome to the fucking drunk show, guys.
I got a mustache.
This mustache.
Johnny, I want your hair and mustache. Give it to me.
All right.
We don't have shit to talk about, but we have shit to talk about.
Call the studio. Call the studio.
We have fucking
lame bastards. Call the studio.
There's 12
I know
people,
you're watching.
We have 12 people watching right now.
Oh. Is that right?
The 12 of you that are up, able to watch us right now, one of you call in.
Yeah, but Johnny, the 12 of them are all not up and able because they're all disabled in some way.
Well, you must be disabled because that means you ain't going to work tomorrow. You're disabled.
You're not like all the other upstanding fucking people that are watching it later.
Hey, John.
Yeah.
I did have a good idea, though, that I thought we should do.
What's that?
It's either or. It plays on the whole fucking thing that we've done before, would you rather? But this one's called either or.
Okay.
You ready for that?
Yes.
Yeah, I'm ready.
It's a good game.
Yes. Yeah, we've been winging that shit.
All right, I'll start with the first one. I want to hear what everybody has to say, except for fucking Ryan and Juan. So,
yeah, fuck.
Like
yeah.
We were gonna
fuck
talk
Juan.
Anyways.
Wow. I want to hear what everybody has to say, but Ryan and Raymond Noodles.
Juan, yeah. Pass me the jacket.
All right, you ready? Now, would you rather? If you had the ability to fly, but every time you flowed, you were naked, or you had invisibility every time, but every time you were invisible, people talk shit about you.
I want to hear, but see, I like that because I don't want to hear shit people were talking about me, and they couldn't say it in my face.
So you'd rather not fly just to be invisible and hear what they had to say?
Yeah, but you're flying naked.
Yeah, but that's dope. You're flying.
Yeah, but you're invisible. Nobody can see you, dude. You can go anywhere you want.
Well, that's your opinion. John, what is your opinion?
Well, my mind was just blown. Turd love in the chat room. And it's amazing. I'm bombed, and I'm not even paying attention.
One time this idiot pays fuck attention.
Never,
I'm not paying
ever,
attention
ever.
To what's going on in the room. Turd love.
Bye, Turd love.
Turd love in the audience just said, I'll give you a topic. Discuss, and I'm going to pronounce these words wrong because I'm a fucking moron.
Syllable time.
Exactly.
That could have been a true statement coming out of your mouth.
Dude, horrible. I'll give you a topic. Discuss the polymers switch mechanism for bypassing distorted DNA damage. Go.
Yeah, and the polyurethane conflagration
polyurethane
of the fucking obtuse angle of the protractor equals the square root of MC squared. Shut the fuck up, turd love.
No,
no, but that shit.
Turd love, you should just mind your own fucking business.
And go kill yourself.
No, it's not even a cure. You're discussing two different things. Turd love, listen.
That's too much.
If we talk about that right now, right here, right now.
I don't know what that stuff is.
That's, our minds will blow. The fucking guys at Zen Live will be fucking cleaning fucking brain sludge off the fucking walls.
They'll be tight, bro. They'll be mad.
They'll be
tight
so tight.
About that
I'm
shit.
Already bleeding from my ears, all
can't
right?
Can't do that. We can't.
Let's get back on fucking topic.
Yeah,
I got a new question.
Topic.
I got a new question.
Pay fucking attention, Johnny.
John, I got a new
Seriously,
question for you.
Bastard.
I got a new question. Ready? Right, and I'm asking you.
All right.
Now, what would you rather? Would you rather always have a popcorn kernel in your throat forever? Or would you rather have Cheeto fingers forever? So every shit you touched, you had Cheeto fingers, or you always had a fucking popcorn kernel in your shit.
Listen, Turd Love, you're 100% correct.
Oh
Billy,
God.
This fucking
Billy,
asshole.
Oh my God!
Shall I not fucking even talk
I
to you? Billy would have known.
I can only
Turd
do
love,
one thing at once.
Billy would have known, Turd Love. You're right. You're 100% correct. But anyway, to answer your question, Kenny. To answer your question... I'd rather
worst.
Have a kernel stuck in my throat.
What?
Really?
Yes.
Cheeto fingers is kind of dope.
Seriously.
How is Cheeto
fingers? You can always lick your finger. You can always lick your finger and it tastes good.
That's my question. If you lick it, you're always tasting Cheetos. You're getting a little Cheeto shit on it.
Word.
What happens when you go inside of a nice prime piece of ass? Does Cheeto get in there and then they get infected?
Exactly.
They get infected with Cheetos.
No, Cheeto
no,
infection.
There's too many. There's too many.
Don Cheeto goes in there.
No, there's too many. No, there's too many.
There's too many what, Johnny? You're trailing off again.
What are you looking for?
My name is Johnny.
That's Johnny's brain.
So my name is Johnny.
It's actually funny.
What happens when you stick a cheater on an asshole?
It's actually funny.
Johnny was not born. He was hatched from a Cheeto.
Mini Tank Rudy says, "Damn, Johnny, relax with the whole ADHD."
Seriously,
Yeah, I should relax, but I can't. It's horrible.
You really are the worst.
All right, so I'm not gonna ask you another question. I'm gonna go right to Ryan.
Oh yeah, good luck.
Ryan says fucking 14 words every episode, but Ryan.
But he said 47 today.
I thought it was an average of
12. Ryan, would you rather wipe your ass with sandpaper for the rest of your life or wipe your ass with Saran wrap for the rest of your life?
Sandpaper, I love that feeling.
What?
Huh?
You've never tried it?
No. You know,
it grinds it a little bit. It depends. You got to get fine grade, first of all. And it grinds it a little bit, but it gets everything off nice and fucking. It gets everything clean.
Is that where you shop for your toilet paper at Home Depot?
Oh, Frank, shut the fuck up. Your mind was just blown. Thought, for a split second, you thought that was a good idea.
Hey, guys, what happened to Vinny?
No, I'm not you.
Yeah, where's Vinny?
He's in the home country.
He's not in the home
country. He went back home?
Vinny is in Vinny's in the sewer. He
went back home.
Home. Yeah. He went down, though. He didn't go, like, up and across.
Well, he doesn't upgrade. He downgrades that guy.
He downgrades.
He's a downgrader.
And he's in the sewer. He's currently under Times Square by now. I mean, he jumped in the sewer today at about 4 o'clock. So I figure he's down by the city by now, right?
If you put Vinny in the ground to grow a plant would grow, but it would be a pot of sauce. Like, instead of a tomato, it'd be a full-blown aluminum fucking pot.
It wouldn't be a starting point. Yeah. It'd just be made sauce.
It'd be made sauce.
Made sauce.
Hey, Vin, if you're listening, fuck you.
I hope you die.
I hope you die. Fuck you.
Seriously. From the bottom of my heart, right here.
And if you are listening, call.
Yeah.
Call up right now.
Nah,
we
don't call
it.
I don't want to hear your voice. You make me sick.
There's another good one.
I hope you set yourself on fire.
You know what's so sad? Just sitting here. I had another ADHD moment. I just completely
spaced out. Of course. You probably think it's nothing to do with anything.
Your whole life.
And I'm thinking to myself, there is no different thought process that goes through my mind when we have a planned show and we don't plan anything at all.
Of course.
And that's bad, right?
What? What are you talking about, dude?
Stop, you fucking guy.
He's a fan. What am I talking about? It's really...
You just open your mouth and words come out.
No.
You don't even connect or
no,
make sense.
No, am I really on a completely
Johnny's
different
like
plane?
A fucking minion, bro.
Seriously.
Am I really on a... different plane there?
You're like
think
a,
about
you're
it.
You're like a plane on autopilot, bro.
So hold on. You think this system's that advanced for an autopilot? You're completely wrong. All right? That's number one. Number two.
Look how angry he gets.
Simple things up. Number one, how we are when we're drunk, how we are when the show is planned.
John,
two simple
constructs
up.
Somebody just emailed me.
Oh.
Scumlord42 wants to know, John, did you ever attempt suicide?
Yes.
Good. And,
yes.
And,
yes.
Wait, was it successful? Was it successful?
It's a live blog. We have a live blog. We have so many blogs, so many tweets. And...
blogs.
Good. All I said was good. Because they were glad to see that, John.
Obviously, it wasn't successful because he's still breathing.
I once committed suicide.
Johnny's too sick.
You convinced me to bury you, and you got brought back to life.
I once committed suicide.
Dr. Graveyard, huh? Frank, I got one more for
you. Can't keep a good man down.
I got one more for him. He's the only one that's going to answer a fucking
answer.
Johnny!
Shut the fuck up for a second. You asked me a question, and I start answering, and you cut me the fuck off.
Silence! Silence!
The fuck?
Dildos.
You want me to say how I committed suicide or not?
That wasn't
the question,
Jonathan. Jonathan, Santa. My name is Johnny. I have Santa in my name.
I'm sorry to bring this up. That happened to be exactly the question.
Exactly the question.
So,
all right, shut the fuck up, everybody. Shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up. We got
Am I telling my suicide story or not?
That wasn't the question, you piece of fucking basura. But go ahead. We want to hear it. Everybody quiet.
I really don't, but he's going to say it anyway.
Keep it in fucking 20 seconds.
Seriously.
I was sitting in front of my...
Make
my,
it a soliloquy.
My little sister's Mac computer.
One, and, two, three,
fuck you, Frank.
Five.
And I took a couple of shots of Clorox. I was just completely done with my life. And I did. And somebody actually came, and thank you for that. And stuck their fingers down my throat.
Who was this?
I'm not saying.
Who is this?
So he's neither dead nor clean. So it didn't work. It didn't work.
Well, I actually have a picture the moment before the woman stuck the fingers down your throat.
No, don't.
So it, Raymond, you got that?
It was a woman.
Raymond Noodles.
Nope. Bring that up to the camera.
Just like that.
I have the picture. Look at that fucking picture.
Mas.
That's the lady in that
Yeah,
because
I speak fucking Spanish.
Mas means, oh.
No, you're done now.
Juan, your phone sucks.
Juan, get the fucking Galaxy 3, bro.
Throw it out the window.
Get the fucking Galaxy 4, the Galaxy 8.
Rebecca, I'm sorry. That wasn't supposed to be shown.
No,
keep
talking.
That was it.
Kenny, you had a question?
Yeah, I got a question for Frank. Fuck Johnny and fuck his life.
What do you mean, worst story?
Terrible story.
Yeah. All right, Frank.
Ninja spots.
The last one, Frank.
Blow the fuck up.
Frank, the last one.
Yes.
Now, would you rather smell a fart all day, all the time, that nobody else could smell, or have everyone think that you smelled like a fart, but you don't?
That I smelled like a fart?
Would you rather
smell a fart? I got the first part. What was the second part again?
Everybody that walks around you thinks that you farted, but you didn't.
Oh, fuck.
Which fucking would you rather?
I think I'd rather just like stand in front of a bus.
No, that's not the equivalent.
That isn't an option.
You torch. Fuck, dude. That is a good one.
That's a brain tickler.
You no brain.
You already smell like a fart, so pick that one.
Dude, honestly, you're fucked either way, man.
No, you're fucked
either way.
I don't want to hear your shit.
Oh.
Don't spew anything.
I don't want to hear your shit, Frank.
All right.
I don't want to hear your shit.
I don't want to hear Frank
bring
talk.
That picture up again of the girl, the woman at moments before.
I guess we can do that. Fucking Raymond. I mean, we're gonna go fucking backwards,
dude.
Shit is so whack and fudgy and fucking stale.
There's the picture. All right,
there's John.
You're viewing.
And there's fucking John. He should have died, but he didn't.
Whoopty fucking
fuck?
Do.
Why are you revisiting this shit for, man?
I see a tear.
Dude, why are you?
I think we should go to a goddamn
commercial. Yes.
We gotta sort things out here. We have to make friends.
You guys are ripping into my fucking dark.
We gotta make fucking friends. And if you don't want to be friends with us, we don't want to be friends with you.
Thursday night, October 24th, ZenLive.tv and its broadcasters are transforming its annual Masquerade Ball to a ghostly rock showcase at Garcia's, the zombie child of the Capitol Theater. Come party with some spooky, sexy, scary rock acts, including East, Left in the Attic, Set the Charge, and Danger Hole. $7 to get through the door, but only $5 if you come dressed up. There will be prizes for best dressed, sinful games for the mischievous, and more. Doors open at 6 p.m. Bands start at 8 p.m. 21 plus only, and professional drinkers welcome.
Sing we now, sing for the year, sing for the laugh and sing for the tear. Sing we now, just for today, maybe tomorrow, good love and take it away. Sing we now, sing for the year, sing for the laugh and sing for the tear. Sing we now, just for today, maybe tomorrow, good love and take it away.
the Daza Entertainment Network on ZenLive.tv.
He never even fucking... Oh, are we on?
Yep.
Oh, shit. Hey, guys, what's going on? Hey. Oh, wow.
Wow.
Oh, Gypsy. Bad timing. Oh, God.
That's horrible.
Kenny, what's up, man?
Hi, Frank. I heard
how you doing?
What's going on? Mini Tank Rudy pointed out that Frank isn't wearing a band shirt. It must be a new kind of record.
Yeah, 2 weeks in a row. Two weeks in a row.
And he's right.
I decided, you know, I just came straight from work. I didn't have time to get a band shirt. And, you know, I didn't have time to change. So.
Yeah, we can start that. We can start that. We're going to start.
Johnny, you know what I do for a living, right?
No, I don't give a fuck what you do.
Give hand jobs?
No, I chop down trees, man. So you motherfuckers can have paper towels.
I don't give a fuck.
You know what I mean?
I don't give a fuck.
So you're the brawny man.
Fuck you, Frank.
Yeah, I'm growing my... As you can see, I'm growing my mustache and beard back. You know what I mean?
Do you double as Mr. Clean in the front?
He's working on the Transporter 5.
Don't open a trunk. Don't look at a trunk, you fucking jerk.
We decided outside over a cigarette on break that we're going to do a segment called B-Movie... Something about B-Movies. We're going to talk about B-Movie... We're gonna talk about.
you sound like Jimmy from South Park.
I felt like that old style fucking Pee Wee Herman doll that you wind up, you know. it was like, wah? Anyway.
Johnny's reliving his childhood.
I am.
Look away.
Yeah, right. Horrible.
Molestation.
Yeah, a lot of.
Oh, scary.
A lot of molestation.
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 That was all that damn molestation.
Speaking about relieving the.
Relieving?
It's my Spanish. Come on.
We
you got
two fucking
it.
Retards here tonight.
It's going around, dude.
Nobody can
re-living.
Talk.
Reliving. They're hooked on phonics, except he got hooked on me.
Oh,
Surge and McDonald's for Johnny here.
Oh, hell yeah.
Surge and McDonald's.
Thank God
yeah.
I never.
Let me get six double cheeseburgers, and by the time you fucking drive out of McDonald's, the bag's out the fucking window.
Yep. Remember that back
that
in the
was,
day?
That was when he was a fucking. Was
fucking 400 pounds.
That was when he was just like a massive blob of everything that's unholy.
I missed that, Johnny.
Let me ask you a question. Well, back then, when you walked, did you break cement floors with your weight?
Dude.
Yeah, Ryan the illegitimate.
Yeah, this motherfucker got jokes.
Yes.
Ryan the illegitimate got jokes on you,
this
bro.
This little white motherfucker got jokes, huh?
Nah, I never broke your cement, but you know what used to happen?
Don't lie.
My thighs used to rub together.
Oh. Did you smell the bacon grease? Did you smell bacon grease when that happened?
Johnny, you just oozed along the sidewalks, didn't you?
Oh,
you were like that. You were like that ooze in Ghostbusters 2 in the fucking sewer.
And I
just kept coming up through cracks in the city.
But I was everywhere.
Yeah, that shit was everywhere too.
I was everywhere.
You were the ooze.
I was the fattest motherfucker. One of the fattest motherfuckers in Borchester. And I was everywhere. I was everywhere. That was the best part.
Oh man.
My life was completely different when I was almost 400 pounds.
God.
Completely different.
God, I bet you wish you could have just.
Black Explorer days. Yeah. Yeah,
Black Explorer.
Rudy's right.
What's that, Black Explorer?
Explain. You're a fucking
expand upon that subject.
It was almost like a fucked up vehicle with fucked up people.
No, I understand the vehicle.
That did fucked
part,
up shit.
Right.
That's all it was.
Wow, so that
you
told
actually,
us absolutely nothing.
They actually carted your fat ass around in this Ford.
Oh, oh,
Ryan the illegitimate is following his father's footsteps, not doing a fucking thing.
Wait, so wait, whoa! Did we just learn something right now?
What did we learn?
I don't know, Papa Frank.
Johnny's his father,
Papa Frank.
No, I'm not your papa, motherfucker.
Are you sure?
Eyes, are you sure?
Look at the eyes.
Your head's too small.
Dude, I've seen you fucking...
Your head's way too small.
I saw you fucking a trash bag once or twice.
18 years ago?
Hey, you know what it is right now? It's October. If you guys don't understand this. It is October. You know what's good in October? Horror flicks.
Yes.
I thought it was pumpkins.
Horror flicks are good.
Pumpkins.
Well, pumpkin seeds, pumpkin brews... Pumpkin ales.
Pumpkin pie.
But I'd like to see
pumpkin spice latte.
This is the graveyard shift. It is the fucking story flagship show of me. It's the flagship show of Johnny. And we also would like to see...
And...
No, it's me and Johnny's shit. It's me and Johnny's shit. You ain't shit to nobody. But the first question does go to you, because you're a live, able body.
Yeah, go ahead.
So, Frank, what is your favorite B-horror flick?
Like, it has to be, like, a really shitty...
It's got to be a dumpy B type of fucking garbage horror flick, but it's funny and shit. Like, well, what do you think? And we'll tell you.
Oh, God. I'd have to go with Attack of the 50-Foot Woman.
That's a pretty decent... Do you see that, John?
Piece of shit.
Let me ask you a question, Frank. That 50-Foot Woman, did you tap that?
Yep.
Hell yeah. I ride right up into that.
You got to climb up there, dude.
Get right into it, dude.
You climb right up there.
Johnny, what about you?
I would have to go with Feast. Feast 1 and 2. And
what happens in that?
What's that?
Oh, my God. These creatures...
This is the only movie Johnny saw.
Yeah, yo, these creatures come out of nowhere and they rape everything. Men, women, children.
Babies.
They produce this sick shit. It's called Feast. Check it out. Feast 1 and 2.
And that's the premise. That's the entire movie.
Just rape everything. And their semen, if it hits airborne, it becomes acidic. And if you get it on you, forget about it. Like, you melt.
It's kind of like Aliens.
It's kind of like living every day in Portchester.
Basically.
Pretty much.
Yeah. All right. Well, what about you, Ryan? I mean, I know you've only been on this planet for about 9 years. But what is your fucking favorite horror flick?
He's a big nine. A big nine.
Eh. I'm a big nine, but my wife tells me I'm a four. But what am I supposed to do about that?
Anyways, I'm going to have to go with Feeding the Masses.
Oh, wow.
Another one I've never heard of.
It's an apocalypse zombie movie.
Yeah. And what year did it come out? Like, yesterday? Like,
no, that's the bet that right there. That's a good fucking movie.
That's not a B movie.
Yes, it is.
That's not a classic B movie.
As a matter of fact, the entire premise is a art film student who's obsessed with the Hindenburg doing nothing but looking for weed in the zombie apocalypse.
Yes.
That's the entire premise.
That's like a
Are you sure film. You guys didn't make this shit like last night?
It sounds like.
And then act like it's a fucking movie.
No, it sounds like we really didn't.
But, you know, I don't know about the movie.
It sounds like the movies. It sounds like movies they filmed.
Charles Bronson said he got a good movie.
What?
Charles
Bronson over there.
Thriller is fucking sick.
Go fucking kill yourself.
It's a music video.
Go fucking kill yourself right
it's
now.
It's a music
video. Yeah, it's not a movie.
Oh my God! This is what happens.
All these jokesters in here, Ken.
What about Killer Clowns from Outer Space?
Yes.
Dope movie.
Yes.
Dope movie.
God, I was gonna think of that one.
It's actually funny. Minnie
fucking hate you
Rudy.
Even more now.
Movie.
We got Minnie Take Rudy in the chat room who actually said Killer Clowns from Outer Space.
Well, no, Kenny said it first.
I said it first. Minnie
said it.
Minnie
fucking
Kenny
did.
Tootie Rudy.
Fuck him.
Why don't you go back to fucking the elementary school that you came from, Tootie?
Probably
you know,
the same
all them
that
girls.
You came from.
With all them girls. All
right. How about Lawnmower Man?
Yes.
Oh, yep.
Yeah.
He was half retarded, but that motherfucker was tight about being half retarded.
mowing that fucking grass.
Yeah. Tell him, Gypsy, what's your favorite fucking B movie?
Tell us.
Gypsy is our fucking producer. That dude's dope. His fucking flavors go from beyond fucking edible to unedible. So what's your fucking flavor?
He's a co-host on a show called the Hangover Takeover.
Yeah, you didn't know. It's on Monday night.
Check it out.
Jew Boogie. All those motherfuckers. They cool.
Yep.
What's your bullshit?
I would have to say Werewolf of London.
Yeah.
Good.
That was good. Wow. Fuck you guys are stealing my ideas, both of you.
Your ideas.
I'm
first, motherfucker.
Yes,
I know. But
Johnny, Toxic Avenger.
Toxic Avenger.
Come on,
yo. Toxic Avenger.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Toxic Avenger is dope, yo.
That's a good one too. You know what?
He was out of New Jersey.
I want to retract my Feast.
Well, you ain't
and I'm gonna go
shit.
With, if we're going with classic B, Evil Dead.
Yeah.
I'm a huge Evil Dead fan. Huge.
Evil Dead.
And not the new Evil Dead.
No,
hell's not.
I actually have
listen,
that
don't hate.
On my
the
Xbox
new Evil Dead was
kind of
dope.
It.
I don't care what you guys say. It was cool.
Nah, not compared to the original,
you,
man.
Just fuck you.
Yeah. Right, well, oh shit! Well. Illegitimate.
Wow, Ryan's got some words.
Yeah,
tonight.
Today you put a couple shots in an underage kid.
You put a couple shots, you take Vinny away.
Don't underestimate this dude. He fucking created Words with Friends.
Oh, there he is. There he is.
That's the creator.
We have the lowest viewership tonight, and Ryan's doing the most.
Wait a second. I wonder why. The man can't even find the shirt that fits him properly. He created Words with Friends. Are you fucking kidding me?
Big and Tall doesn't have anything short and thin.
Hey, we got about fucking 5 minutes. We got another segment that we could talk about, and it's called What's the Felon? What's the Perp? Would you guys like to do that? Would
yes,
you like
I
to
nah,
do
not tonight. No.
No, I want to do it.
No?
No.
John wants to do it.
Let's do a vote. House vote. We can be like Congress and not all right, anything.
Do it quickly, though, because we have 47 seconds left. All right,
Wait. I moved to shut down government and let no one else reopen it.
Well, I moved to say that illegitimate vote don't mean shit to nobody.
Damn it, he got it.
All right, Frank, what do you say? That's 32 points. No. Burr. Kenny.
I'm Tea Partying right now.
You're doing
I'm on the
Gypsy.
Boat.
Let's do it.
Let's do it. All right,
throw it up real quick, because fuck Frank.
All right. Thank you very much.
Now, this is, what is it? What do you do, eat people?
Necrophilia, sex with dead people.
Sex with dead people. You have one, two, or three. Now, you have to choose one, two, or three.
I can't see. That's
oh, which
something.
One they
three.
Got sex with?
Well, which one had sex with a dead person?
Oh.
Three.
You make that bigger?
No.
Oh.
No, can you make your fucking eyes work better? Yeah. How about that?
Three things. Hey, look at the smile on his face. Nah, his thumb is up.
There we go.
Nah, two fucked his dead wife. That's what I'm going with.
Who ate somebody?
No, who fucked the dead bitch?
Who fucked the dead bitch? I'm going to go with two.
It's two.
I'm going to go with one.
Two.
One.
What is it? It says it on the beginning of it.
Perp one.
One. Perp one.
I think that's
Ed Gein. Ed Gein, ladies and gentlemen.
Ed Gein?
No, I think that's Otis something.
I thought he ate people, Ed Gein.
All right, number two. Let's do it quick. Number two. What is this perp known for, Gyps? What is this perp?
Molester.
This is a pet molester. Who molested a pet out of these three people? Who had fucking sex
for a
with a fucking pet?
Well, I'll take Johnny's vote since he's incapacitated at the moment. I'm going to go with number three.
Oh, my God.
Hey, how about you, Ryan?
Number three, that wonderful young man wearing a fancy hat.
Ryan, who fucked the pet? And you know goddamn well I was there that night. Who fucked the pet?
I got a little inside knowledge.
Wait, what's the reward for getting this right?
No, oh my God, prison time. There is no reward.
So, right, saltine, yeah, saltine crackers, saltine
Let's
crackers.
Let's keep it going. We got like
I'm
2 minutes, motherfucker.
It's two.
All right, the motherfucker who slept with some fucking dog was number one.
Really?
Yeah, it was a cartoon character.
Guys didn't know? Oh, never mind.
I seen it. No, actually, it's number three.
Oh, God, I was
What's this one? What is this one? What does it say on the whole board?
Child molester.
Who's the child molester out of these three? Now, number one,
child molester.
Number one is actually Bill Gates when he was a child.
Oh, no.
Number two is, I think it's somebody we know. I think it's somebody we know. And number three has great hair.
I want to go with two.
Kind of looks like you, Kenny.
Well.
It does kind of like you.
Well, you said that before the show, and I agree with you still to this day. John, who says such a thing? Because God forbid...
Two.
Did you have a heart attack over there? Did your arteries clog up? I haven't heard nothing from you.
Oh, almost.
Johnny stroked out on us.
Two? The winner is what?
Three.
It was me. It was me the whole time. Well, that's a future picture of me. Let's get the last one, and then we'll get our plugs in. And then we'll get our fucking hair plugs in. What is this?
I need hair plugs.
Pooper eater.
Who ate shit in public and got arrested for it? The evidence points to one. Now, number three has no teeth, but
the evidence sometimes lies.
I've said
three looks way too happy. I think it's him. He seems like he had a good
I've
job.
Said two all this time. I want to say three.
Two.
Three.
Two, two? It was three.
Yes!
It was three, you fuck. You said two, you fucking
I said three. I said two this whole time, so I'm going to say three.
John,
fucking ears, Kenny.
John, tell him about the fucking Halloween party.
fuck this game. Fuck your little fucking papers over here.
Entrance is free.
The entrance is free. Yay.
Do you guys want free things?
This is the den of hell that we've created.
That will be beer.
Number two, tampon tournament, $5 to enter. That's gonna be fucking awesome.
Number eight, bring cash, cause this place is so fucking stale that you have to have cash. They don't take fucking credit cards.
No MasterCard, no Visa, no American Express.
None of that bullshit.
Cash, bullshit. Money, motherfucker.
Old checks, school Gindaloon fucking event. If you don't have cash and you ain't got tomatoes.
Kibasa,
yo, if you sneak your own fucking alcohol in, give me a shot. That's number four.
That's okay.
Number 17.
Because we ain't making shit.
You got Bud, make sure you smoke me up. Because if I catch you smoking without having me in the rotation, I'm going to be like, what the fuck?
You're dead.
You're dead, boy.
What the fuck?
You're dead.
If you want to show your tits, that's cool.
That's cool, too.
That's so cool,
we got a contest,
man,
for the fucking craziest and the sluttiest.
And the wildest nipples.
Yeah, costume bullshit.
Word.
Trust me, if your costume's awesome, you'll get a fucking prize for it. Face painting. You get your half your face painted with the sugar skull.
Bring your children.
But that's first come, first serve. Party starts at 10 o'clock at the Polish Club. Kind of a dump.
God, I hate that place.
Kind of a dump.
Oh, my Lord. And after this, we're going to David's.
Yeah, we're going to David's.
So if you want
to
come out tonight, we'll be at Davy Burns. Come there so we can not buy you a drink.
Yeah.
We'll probably make fun of you, but you should laugh at it because we're famous. Yeah. Fuck you. This is the graveyard shift. That's Dr. Graveyard. That's Nobody the Nuns. And that's Frankie Bones. And they calls me the king of all corpses. Gypsy the engineer. You can go fuck everybody.
I forgot about Solomon Ben over there.
Oh, Solomon Grundy. He's
Juan,
good
thank
too.
Thank you for fucking coming in.
Yeah, no doubt, no doubt.
Fuck you. Welcome to the graveyard shift.
Peace.
Good night.
Welcome to the graveyard shift. Doesn't matter who you're with. Come on in and take a sip. Ride along with the graveyard shift.